all of a sudden fell to being an unranked team, and all of a sudden went on a nice little run to the conference tournament, conference championship, including beating number one Purdue. You know, we just talked about the job Shaka Smart's done. Greg Gard has to be the most underrated coach in the country based on what his accomplishments are in his time at Wisconsin.
Yeah, Greg is great. He, you know, he just wins. He wins. And yeah, I mean, what, they went into a downward spiral. What, they lose 6 out of 8 or something of that nature? And then all of a sudden, we found out Chucky Hepburn could score, and they were like, you know, 9 and 10 guys playing. What I like about the Badgers right now is all these games against Purdue and Illinois. I mean, they are playing and have just recently played very, very tough championship-level teams.
Well, and not just in the conference, right? They tested themselves in the non-conference schedule as well, right? They, you know, I mean, Virginia was a fringe team, but they played Tennessee early in the year. They played Arizona, right? I think I remember they went to Arizona, and sure, you know, the result was not great, but this was a team that got tested early. They beat Marquette when Marquette was playing very well early in the season.
Yeah, but let's be honest. I mean, frankly, what happened in November, December, and January doesn't matter right now. It's who's hot, who's healthy, who has the momentum, and who has the confidence right now. So,
well, speaking of, as you look at that at the South, and let's look at that region, there's another Marquette coach in there with Texas A&M, who just went on a little run in his conference tournament, which is Buzz Williams, the former Marquette head coach, who has Nebraska, Big Ten matchup in the first round, and a collision course potentially if he could get past it with Houston.
Yeah, that's a quick matchup. Buzz is great in preparation. He's great in motivating, and I did see them twice in Nashville, and everyone has Houston going a long, long way. I think they're going to have a tough time getting by Texas A&M.
So now we've talked about Houston, we've talked about Texas A&M, we've talked about Wisconsin, we've talked about Marquette. I know you like Florida a lot and you like their coach.
The problem with Florida is in the first 5 minutes or less of the Auburn game, their 7-foot center went down with a broken leg, and he's a game changer. He's a great offensive rebounder, a shot blocker, so they're playing without their 7-foot center now.
So now we're talking about a region where I've gone through all these teams. Oh, by the way, how about Duke and Kentucky? They're also still in that region. So let's dive into the South, because this is the one we got to count on. And let's start first, Marquette. Do you see any reason why they don't roll in their first round game? Do we know anything about Western Kentucky?
I see Marquette beating Western Kentucky convincingly.
Now, this is one I don't see as convincing, and I do worry about. I worry about Wisconsin and James Madison. Remember last year, Colgate was not an easy first round disposal for Wisconsin. Wisconsin, I don't know. I worry about that game. I have Wisconsin advancing over James Madison, but I think that's going to be a tough one.
I do too. I mean, 31 wins is 31 wins. That's anything but a joke.
Only 4 teams in the country with 30 wins or more, and Badgers are playing one of them.
Yeah, they have a very highly regarded coach. I do think that's going to be a tough game. Again, I think the best thing Wisconsin has going for them is, you know, playing Purdue and Illinois. You know, I don't see them letting up. I just don't see them letting up. And again, the biggest challenge is, they got Duke ahead of them, and they just finished with Illinois and Purdue. So I just think they're going to prevail.
I mean, I look at the minutes they played, and I know they're young and, you know, and it's kids and all that, but you look at that game, AJ Storr, 40 minutes, Chucky Hepburn, you mentioned 38 minutes, you know, that was against Purdue. And then they had to come back the next day and grind it out with Illinois, right? AJ Storr, 38 minutes, Chucky Hepburn, 36 minutes. You look at the cross starting lineup, 35 minutes. And now all of a sudden, you know, they could have those. I mean, if they get past James Madison, then they get Duke. Again, assuming Duke, assuming Duke gets past Vermont, which Vermont some people like, but I really you know, I have trouble. I see Marquette in the Sweet 16, and I have them going even further. I have Duke over Wisconsin. Now, you don't there?
My bracket takes a little twist early on because I have Texas A&M beating Houston. I'm probably in the 2 percentile there, but I just have Texas A&M beating Houston.
As do I. I'm in that 2% with you.
Oh, really?
We spent enough time with Buzz Williams,
really?
I think, both where we respect his ability to be the underdog in a spot like that.
And, you know, Houston showed in their 30-point loss, hard to say that, to Iowa State, that they can get cold. I mean, they're a tremendous defensive team, Houston, but, you know, they got exposed a little bit with their shooting. So I actually have Texas A&M playing Wisconsin. I have Wisconsin beating Duke. And, you know, how much of a homer do you want to be? But I've seen Duke a couple of times. I don't think it's a great Duke game. The big kid is a lottery pick, the 7-footer. But if Wisconsin plays Duke, I think it's going to be a very close game.
And speaking of, I believe he is officially a third-team All-American. Tyler Kolek, officially a second team, the leading vote-getter among all second-team All-Americans. So congrats to Tyler Kolek from Marquette.
That's
last
amazing.
Year, a third-team All-American. This year, a second-team All-American for Marquette's point guard. So, all right, so you have A&M versus Wisconsin. I have Texas Tech versus Marquette. And then I'm going to my Elite Eight, and I have Duke and Marquette. That is my Elite Eight, Duke and Marquette.
I have Marquette in Wisconsin. Jeez, how did that happen?
Wow.
And you know what? I'm not playing too big of favorites. I just, without too much recency, I just think that when you play Purdue, when you play Illinois, when you play in those level games, I mean, are they going to be phased by Duke? I don't think so. You know, what's his name? Flipowski, you know, he's supposed to be a high lottery pick. Jeez, they play Zach Edey every 2 weeks. I mean, I just don't think 7-footer who moves a little.
Yeah, but Zach Edey's a guy who they're used to playing. They've played these guys now like, you know, 8 times, and not all the Badgers have been there, you know, the whole time. But they're used to playing a player like that. I mean, it's so different. I mean, when you're playing against all these, you know, 5-star Duke kids who you've only played against in AAU, you know, as a kid, right? I mean, this is going to be a very different matchup than seeing a team for the 3rd or 4th time.
Yeah, it works both ways. I agree with you. The question is whether they could, if they could slow down Duke a little. Keep in mind, this isn't a Badger team.
The Badgers can.
Right,
Badgers can move.
They're not looking to score in the low 50s and low 60s anymore. They're running up and down the court, and they're scoring in the 80s.
I don't know. For some reason, when I look at that Illinois team, I feel like Duke is like a more skilled version of that Illinois team. You know, when you look at who each of their best players are and what they have. That's why I want to pick. I love that
certainly
idea.
Certainly a more highly regarded team, more higher recruits. But, I mean, Shannon on Illinois, I think he's better than anybody Duke has.
As good a scorer, certainly.
That's for sure.
As, you know, a better scorer. And then Waupun's the legend of Waupun, who has been unstoppable against Wisconsin this year, you know, which for Illinois, which is incredible. So, all right.
Well, one of the themes which we should hit on a little here is, because it will probably come up with, you know, the discussion about Kentucky, is older teams tend to do better in these tournaments, the more mature thing. Unless, of course, you're dealing with sometimes the Connecticuts of the world or something like that. But I think the two most talented teams in the entire tournament are Connecticut and Kentucky. That being said, Kentucky with, you know, 4 potential first-round draft choices right now, you know, what, 3 of them? What, 3 of them are freshmen? Or it doesn't play out all the time.
But we've seen that, right? We've seen where, like, all these young guys aren't ready for it and are out earlier than you'd expect. You also see freshman click, not just Carmelo Anthony, right, who did it all the way to winning a national championship for Syracuse 20 years ago. But we've seen Kentucky teams, you know, built like this one, you know, come together. And I'm not talking like the Anthony Davis, that team was built a little different, but like the team that the Badgers, you know, the team the Badgers played in the Final Four, it was a very, very young, very talented Kentucky team. I would say maybe more talented than this one, but and maybe more developed than this one. But I don't, this to me feels like a Kentucky, everyone's picking Kentucky. Everyone's feeling Kentucky. I don't think Kentucky's getting the Sweet 16.
Well, it's interesting because this tournament for years has become so guard-oriented, and Kentucky has by far the best guards in this tournament. That being said, you got the 7-2 big on Connecticut. You got Zach Edey, so you got a little different element there because, you know, how do you, it's hard to stop 7-2, 7-3.
I don't know. In the tournament, it feels like I'm more on the guard, you know, guards and McNeese State can swarm Zach Edey. And you know, like, well, I feel like that stuff happens in the tournament. Like, I don't see a lot of those like 7-foot guys dominate NCAA tournaments.
The reason I keep bringing up Purdue is I think they learned a lesson last year from Fairleigh Dickinson.
Or from St. Peter's.
What?
From St. Peter's, right? They, St. Peter's got Purdue, right?
No, I think it was Fairleigh Dickinson. I think it was St. Peter's the year before.
Oh, right.
Got Kentucky.
Oh, right.
St.
Right.
Peter's got Kentucky. And I think it was Fairleigh Dickinson last year who beat this Purdue team.
So 2 years ago, St. Peter's beat Purdue in the Sweet 16.
Yeah.
That was 2 years ago. So and who did Purdue lose to last year? You think they
Dickinson.
Really lose to Fairleigh? So they lost back
Wasn't
to back.
Fairleigh Dickinson?
So they lost back to back to New Jersey teams.
Oh.
So St. Peter's and Fairleigh Dickinson. Yeah, and they clearly didn't learn their lesson in their loss to St. Peter's. That they then came back and lost to Fairleigh Dickinson
was
the next
two
year.
2 years ago, that was when St. Peter's beat Kentucky, didn't they?
Yeah, so St. Peter's was the 15 seed, beat, I think, the 2-seeded Kentucky in the first round, beat someone in the second round, right. And then beat Purdue in the Sweet 16.
Yeah.
I mean, so to me,
that's how their coach got the Seton Hall job.
Right, Shaheen Holloway then became the coach of Seton Hall. But so to me, I don't think it's that Purdue learned their lesson because they would have learned it from St. Peter's and never lost to Fairleigh Dickinson. I mean, I think this is a this is just a matchup thing. And Will Wade, the coach of McNeese State, who's got the best little team money can buy, and now you could do it legally, he turned around, I think last year, they lost 24 games. And he said, this year, we're going to win 24 games. By the way, he won 30 games.
Well, let me ask you this question then. I'm looking down at my bracket. So do you likewise, you have McNeese State beating Gonzaga?
I have McNeese State.
I do.
Yes, I have McNeese State. Now, I always, every year I have a 12-13, a 12 playing a 13. Do we need to take a quick break, Joshua, here? All right, we're going to hit that regional because it makes no sense to go in whatever order we're going in, but that's the order we're going. We're going south, and we're going to head to the Midwest. We're going to talk about Purdue and the Zags and McNeese State and even talk a little Samford and Son as we continue. It is the Bracket Breakdown with David Gruber. I'm Craig Karmazin, ESPN, and Wisconsin On Demand.
More Bracket Breakdown with Craig Karmazin and David Gruber coming up on 94.5 ESPN.
Don't miss the Milwaukee Bucks at Fiserv Forum on March 24th as we celebrate Women's Empowerment Night, presented by BMO. Hear how sport has empowered and influenced women and celebrate what that means to our community. Cheer for some incredible Milwaukee Bucks basketball and support women's empowerment on Sunday, March 24th. For more details and to purchase tickets, visit bucks.com/impact. That's bucks.com/impact.
Don't miss a moment of the basketball tournament action this March at 3rd Street Market Hall, right in downtown Milwaukee. Home to your one-stop, must-stop viewing destination, 3rd Street Market Hall has over 15 locally owned food vendors, a self-serve beer wall with 24 beers on tap, and over 50 HD TVs, plus game day specials. It's the perfect place to work remotely or catch a game between meetings or even over lunch. 3rd Street Market Hall is Milwaukee's downtown home to basketball this March.
For over four decades, one name has stood out as a symbol of excellence in automotive sales and service. It's the Boucher Automotive Group, dedicated to providing exceptional experiences to all of our valued customers.
We will help you find the perfect vehicle within your budget while respecting your time.
With 20 convenient locations, we're the one-stop destination for all your automotive needs.
At Boucher, we're your trusted partner on every mile of your journey. Riding with you every mile since 1977. The Boucher Group has exciting news to share with you. We've expanded to better serve our community.
Introducing Nissan Lake Country, the newest addition to our family.
Step into our showroom and discover our exceptional selection of brand new Nissans.
We're also stocked with the best pre-owned options in the market.
And as we expand, we're not just growing our inventory, we're also growing our team.
So join a team that values your skills and celebrates your success.
Visit us online or in store today and view our current job listings at BoucherCareers.com.
All you have is one chance after an accident, one decision on who to call, one shot to get the help you need. Don't waste it on the one offer you get from your insurance company. Make the one call to Gruber Law Offices. It's the only one you'll need to make. Call us today. Gruber Law Offices. One call, that's all.
That to-do list you have needs one more thing. Chill. It's an easy thing to do. Just crack open an ice-cold Coors Light and chill. Take the afternoon off and binge-watch anything. Go to happy hour and stay for a couple hours. Who's counting anyways? Or hang out with just your dog, because you've had enough human interaction this week. Whatever you do, do it with a Coors Light. Mountain Cold Refreshment made to chill. 2020 Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. Celebrate responsibly.
Are you tired of looking at a dirty, dusty, and cracked garage and looking for a fresh new look? Hi, this is ESPN Milwaukee's Jen Latta, and I'm here to tell you about Floor Shield by Showtime Floors. Using a state-of-the-art coating four times stronger than traditional epoxy, it's tough enough to be used in military bases and airports. Floor Shield is certified as an anti-slip floor and also eco-friendly, all while being UV stable, and my favorite part, easy to clean. This makes it perfect for outdoor spaces, just like your patio. Check it out at ShowtimeFloors.com and work with a specialist to transform your space in as little as one day.
The Bracket Breakdowns continue right now. You're listening to Bracket Breakdown with Craig Karmazin and David Gruber on 94.5 ESPN.
The Bracket Breakdown continues as Pat McAfee shows the Anthony Edwards dunk from last night, which was absolutely insane. All right, so we never even got your winner.
Of what?
Wisconsin and Marquette playing to the death, 20 overtimes in the Elite Eight.
I'll whisper. Marquette.
So we both have Marquette, the two seed, coming out of the South region. How about that?
I just need good seats and a good place to stay in Scottsdale for the Final Four.
Well, how about to the Midwest, where no one cares about my bracket, so I'll give you the spoiler alert. I have another Big East team in the Final Four from the Midwest region. So let's start to look at that bracket as we talked a bunch about Purdue, who you're saying has learned their lessons. So how far do we see Purdue rolling?
I have Purdue going to the Final Four.
All right. So you see Purdue going all the way. So yeah, now
I think a week ago I would have thought Tennessee was their biggest threat. I've seen Creighton play in person several times in the last few years. I really like Creighton a lot. And again, don't forget, they were preseason top 10. Then we could get into the discussion if there's only three teams from the Big East. Would that be wild? Your choice. Look at your choice.
I
say the league is weak. They only come in with three teams, which is pathetic.
And I have all three of them into the final four.
And you have, you have what, Marquette and Creighton in the final four,
along with UConn. So you.
Oh God! You know what's funny? After all these years, I still don't think of UConn being in the Big East.
So I have the Big East not losing a game in the tournament to anyone besides a Big East team.
That's a great story. You know,
that is, and when I was a kid, the Big East put three teams in the Final Four. So
the Mountain West has what, six teams?
Yeah.
Is that right? Six teams from the Mountain West. I'm sure people couldn't name who the heck's in the Mountain West. I know I'd have a problem doing that. Six teams, and the world famous Big East has three teams, and you have three out of three going to the Final Four. That's pretty interesting.
I think it was Rick Pitino and Providence was there the year that they got three teams in. I think it was like Providence, maybe St. John's and Georgetown. I don't know that Syracuse was in it that year, but they actually had three of the four Final Four teams. And that's what I'm seeing it again. I'm seeing it again, but a lot of talk about this McNeese State team. They're playing Gonzaga, the Zags, and Gonzaga, there was talk of them not making the tournament, but you know, midway through the year, they obviously rallied. They're a five seed. Gonzaga is now almost like one of the Blue Bloods. Like they're almost like
absolutely
a Duke or Kentucky, right? It's been 20 plus years, Michigan State, right? Like the teams that you don't have the NCAA tournament without.
You know, their coach never left. He's an absolute legend. He's got guys all over the NBA. He knows how to win. And, you know, I'm maybe talking myself out of it, but once again, McNeese State had 30 wins. Will Wade is big time. You know, he was forced out at LSU, and I assume after this year or next, he'll be right back at a monster school, and he just runs, and recruits.
How about this? Four of their top five scorers shoot better than 40% from three. How's that work for you in the NCAA tournament, right? So you got this fast-paced team who turns you over a lot. They, among the nation's leaders in points off turnovers, four of their top five guys shooting better than 40% from three. I love McNeese State. I love them to get on a roll. And I know this, you know, this could blow up and they could lose to Gonzaga. I have them beating Gonzaga. I have them beating Samford and Suns in the second round.
Oh, you have Samford beating Kansas, huh?
Yeah, Kansas is beat up, right? Dickinson.
I think both of their big pros are going to be back. I think they're going to be back, and you know they were humbled a little. I see.
And they were in a very tough conference, right? Kansas, you know, that Big 12 this year was the best, right?
Gracious,
I think we agree that was the best
top
conference.
To bottom, yeah,
best conference in America.
Absolutely.
So they were tested all year long and all that. By the way, they just flashed on the BPI says that James Madison has a 33% chance to beat the Badgers. 33% chance to beat the Badgers.
They're supposed to be very good,
the
very
BPI.
Well coached, and they won 31 games.
So. But I have McNeese State rolling through Samford, and then I have Purdue versus McNeese State in the Sweet 16. And we've, you know, history doesn't repeat itself, but it rhymes. And you know what? I think I'm trying to do the rhyme, but I'm pretty sure St. Peter's and Fairleigh Dickinson and McNeese State all rhyme, and Zach Edey's going home in the Sweet 16.
Well, I have Purdue beating Kansas.
So I don't know Dana Altman's story that all that well. I mean, you're the college coaching guru, but the stats say that Dana Altman, in his time at Oregon, has not lost a first-round game in the NCAA tournament. You've seen South Carolina play a lot. You know Dana Altman in Oregon. Who are you picking in that 6-11 matchup?
I think South Carolina's personnel is a little better. I saw South Carolina several times this year. I saw them last week in Nashville when I was down there, and I really like the team. You know, they got shell-shocked a little bit by Auburn, but they had a great year. Again, 26 wins, 12-5 in the SEC. Oregon came on a little at the end, but yeah, you're right. The numbers don't lie. I mean, he's a Hall of Fame coach, actually.
And Dana Altman, they've been playing their best basketball, like, in March, right?
And once again, I mean, let's mention that the coach of South Carolina is a longtime Wisconsin assistant. You know, longtime Wisconsin assistant, and he's going to be a finalist for Coach of the Year. I don't know if they did that yet, but he'll be a finalist for Coach of the Year. So
now, as we do bracket breakdown, though, we also must note 12 of the last 15 years, an 11 seed has made the Sweet 16. So 12 of the last 15 years, an 11 seed has made the Sweet 16. I was keeping that in mind when I did my bracket, and mine is New Mexico that I have in the Sweet 16. You know, so out of Duquesne, who I have losing to BYU, NC State, I have losing to Texas Tech, and then Oregon, I have beating South Carolina and then losing to Creighton. I wanted to have 1-11 to the Sweet 16, which I do in the West region, which is New Mexico, who I have beating Clemson and then upsetting Baylor in the second round.
Funny you said that. I do too. I have New Mexico playing Arizona.
Wow. So you also do have an 11 seed. You're a bracket expert.
Yes. I've seen, that's young Patino, right?
Yeah. I mean, that team, New Mexico is they are a reinvented basketball team and you know, but what I was going to say is, and I want to get to this other matchup down below. You've seen a lot of Tennessee. And yeah. A lot of people are saying, you know, Texas could beat Tennessee. Creighton could beat Tennessee. What are you seeing for those Tennessee Volunteers?
Well, Rick Barnes has been around a long time. Rick Barnes is a very successful guy. I mean, I saw that kid score, 40 twice? Or 39 and 40. I mean, he's first team All-American.
Yeah.
And they're a physical team, Tennessee. I mean, I have Tennessee, obviously beating St. Peter's, and I have them beating Virginia. I don't like this Virginia team, obviously. Tony Bennett doesn't. It's amazing. The coaches here that have the Wisconsin flavor with Tony Bennett and Buzz and Wisconsin and Marquette.
And nobody had Virginia.
South Carolina, it's crazy.
I don't say nobody, but people did not have Virginia in the tournament at all. So sometimes those teams that last
but
in
he controls
do something.
Tempo. I mean, he could win the ugliest games. I mean, he could win a game in a tournament in the high 40s, low 50s.
I just don't think they're consistent enough. So even if they win their first game, right, since they have to play in the play-in.
Have them winning because I think because he wins and he knows how to control tempo. So gets an extra game too, huh? I don't know much about Colorado State other than the fact that they win a lot of basketball games. It's interesting what Colorado State and Colorado were both in the play-ins, huh?
Yeah. Now, Dalton Knecht, you mentioned, is first-team All-American. So when they match up with Creighton, I've already given my kind of tease that I don't have Big East teams losing anybody. I think Creighton can get by Tennessee. You've seen Tennessee and Creighton a lot because you watch a lot of SEC and Big East basketball. What does that matchup look like to you?
That's a heck of a matchup. You know, I mean, like I said, Creighton was top 10 early in the season, and they're just really good. So you got high-level coaches, a lot of high-level players. I picked Creighton. I thought that was a tough pick. Tennessee's a little up and down, and I think if you could control a neck and hold them to about 30 points, some of the other guys.
Tennessee has no players. They have I think the highest percentage of points from their starting five of any of the elite teams this year. So if there's an injury, if there's foul trouble, if there's anything, which sometimes you can five's enough in the NCAA tournament. Sometimes with all those TV timeouts, it's not a factor.
Yeah. Oh.
But Tennessee is not deep.
Funny you said that. I mean, sitting there with the timeouts, and I mean, they go to the monitor. It's unbelievable when they go to monitor. I mean, your substitution patterns, if you needed to play seven guys, there's no problem because I can't believe how often they go to the monitor. So these games are long.
Well, that is a big factor when Creighton plays Tennessee, but I then have Creighton over McNeese State in the Elite Eight as the Big East gets its second team of two brackets so far into the Final Four, and you have Purdue joining the Marquette Golden Eagles in the Final Four.
I think, absolutely, I have Purdue there, and I just think their bracket, Purdue's road, is the easiest. you know, of course, he won't end up there. I think it's the easiest of the four by far.
Okay, how about this for a trivia question? Joshy, you can jump in on this one. There are two Division I basketball players with at least 175 rebounds, 175 assists, and 50 steals this season. There's two players, and they both have the same name. What is it?
I've got nothing.
It is Braden Smith from Purdue and Braden Smith from Colgate. The only two players in the country with 175 rebounds, 175 assists, and 50 steals. Braden Smith and Braden Smith.
Not to be confused with Jalen Williams and Jalen Williams and everyone on OKC being named Jalen Williams.
Yes, and Auburn having their own Jalen Williams. And
yes.
Speaking of Auburn, we'll go to the East Regional when we continue as Auburn and Yale will go at it, as well as the national champion UConn and Danny Hurley. We will talk about that East Regional as we continue. It is Bracket Breakdown here on ESPN Milwaukee and Wisconsin On Demand.
More Bracket Breakdown with Craig Karmazin and David Gruber coming up on 94.5 ESPN.
Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin present your Badger Minute. Here's Alex Strofe.
This Badger Minute brought to you by UW Credit Union. For every stage of life, UW Credit Union is here for every you. Proudly serving Wisconsin for over 90 years. Hop in or hop online at uwcu.org to join.
For the 15th time in program history, the Wisconsin women's hockey team is headed to the Frozen Four. With a 4-0 win over St. Lawrence at LeBron on Saturday, the reigning national champion Badgers have the opportunity to defend their crown this weekend in Durham, New Hampshire. Wisconsin will face off with Colgate in the Frozen Four, with the winner headed to the national championship game on Sunday. Clarkson and conference foe Ohio State will face off in the other semifinal. Puck drop between Colgate and Wisconsin set for 6:30 this Friday on ESPN+.
Get no interest for up to 3 years at Pella Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. Don't wait. You have to order by March 31st. Visit PellaWI.com.
This is ESPN Wisconsin's Brad Nortman, here to tell you about my favorite go-to drink. That's Carbliss. Carbliss is a ready-to-drink, handcrafted vodka and tequila cocktail. Even better, it's zero carbs, zero sugar, zero gluten, and just 100 calories. And listen to this, less carbonation. This leads to less bloat. I can indulge in something delicious without having that health guilt. Carbliss is crafted right here in Wisconsin. It has a flavor for everyone, from black raspberry to cranberry, pineapple and lemon, and my favorite, margarita. Find Carbliss online and at a retailer near you. Less is more.
Another MVP has joined the roster at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin.
Dr. Ryan Stefanchek.
Board certified in sports medicine, physical medicine, and rehabilitation, Dr. Stefanchek specializes in non-operative treatment of the spine, chronic pain, all joints, all musculoskeletal problems, and more, emphasizing holistic care first, with a focus on diet, sleep, stress management, and social connections for a patient's well-being. At Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin, there is a difference.
Panic strikes as you realize on Wednesday that Thursday is your anniversary. The reservations? Being secured.
We'll see you at 8.
The gift? Being purchased. Yeah, you've got this. Just like Associated Bank's got you with early pay up to 2 days early on direct deposits. So even though they call you Last Minute Lisa, we'll make your last minute scrambling a bit easier. You've got this with early pay from Associated Bank. See associatedbank.com/checking or ask a banker for details. Member FDIC.
Hey, Drew Scott here.
And I'm Jonathan Scott, reminding you that life's better with a home policy from American Family Insurance. They can help you get just the right protection at just the right price and help you save when you bundle home and auto. Kind of like Goldilocks and the Three Bears. It'll be just right for you. We love a custom build. American Family Insurance. Insure carefully, dream fearlessly. Get a quote and find an agent at AmFam.com.
Products not available in every state. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
It's time for the Marquette Minute on 94.5 ESPN. Marquette fans, Buffalo Wild Wings is the official viewing party location for Marquette road games this season. The next watch party will be March 20th.
22nd at the West Allis Buffalo Wild Wings. Marquette watch parties will continue for the rest of the 2024 season.
It was a slow start for the Big East title game over the weekend, as both Marquette and UConn scoring just 8 points in the first 10 minutes of the game. But once it got going, both teams started to fire away. Cam Jones trying to keep Marquette ahead.
Marquette's got 14-2. Cam Jones to the basket. Layup is good.
Unfortunately, though, UConn would use a second half surge and pull away, winning 73-57. The Golden Eagles will now get ready for the big dance. That happens starting on Friday afternoon at 1 o'clock. 2-seed Marquette taking on 15-seed Western Kentucky at 1 o'clock.
This has been the Marquette Minute on 94.5 ESPN. Check out the Golden Eagles watch party schedule at gomarquette.com/BWW for upcoming locations. The Bracket Breakdowns continue right now. You're listening to Bracket Breakdown with Craig Karmazin and David Gruber on 94.5 ESPN.
Bracket Breakdown continues. David Gruber, Craig Karmazin, and we were talking about potential candidates for coaching jobs. So the Louisville coaching job is maybe the highest profile one that's available with the biggest bucks. I mean, they built an NBA arena a college team in Louisville. Here's the top five candidates that they list. Mick Cronin from UCLA. How about Scott Drew from Baylor? Especially if they lose early to New Mexico, as we both are predicting. How about Pat Kelsey of Charleston? Dusty May of FAU. He's going to be a hot name. He led FAU within one shot by San Diego State of the actual championship game last year. And then Eric Musselman from Arkansas.
Wow, Musselman's name's on there, huh?
Those are the names for Louisville.
Interesting.
But we are going to the name Danny Hurley, who sits atop the East bracket, the national champion who, you know, last year, remember, Marquette beat them, knocked them out of the tournament. You know, they didn't come in as a hot name into the NCAA tournament, but they certainly dominated the tournament last year. I mean, they didn't play a lot of close games, right? And this year has been an incredible, almost coronation of UConn. And it's tough to pick them to lose against anyone. I mean, I see them rolling against FAU, the defending, Final Four team. Then they could run into Auburn. Do you have Auburn going that far to the Sweet 16?
Of course I do.
Yeah,
I have Auburn beating UConn in Boston, Massachusetts.
So in Bruce Pearl's hometown of Boston, the former Wisconsin Milwaukee Panther head coach goes to Boston and knocks out
By the way, while we're in the middle of this, I was rooting hard for Milwaukee UWM.
Yeah.
I mean, Bart Lundy did a great job, and they finished strong.
Man, I feel like that's what we were saying at this time last year, right?
I thought he'd done
a great job there.
I was rooting very hard for Milwaukee and Brown, and they won crushing defeats in their conference tournament. But yeah, they rolled at the end, so just a shout out. I mean, I thought he did a great job.
We were saying that last year. We were like, this, you know, at this time next year, we might be talking about the Panthers in this tournament. And it wasn't that far. I mean,
because Oakland got the reward. Oakland's got to play Kentucky, you know?
Yeah.
If that had been UW Milwaukee, that would have been pretty interesting.
Yeah, it would have been. The Panthers, as you said, a great run. So Bruce Pearl, former coach of the Milwaukee Panthers, grew up in the Boston area as a Big East basketball fan, went to Boston College, right, which was part of the Big East back then. And so you have him in Boston matching up with not only the Big East champion, but the defending national champions. And maybe your bracket this year has a little bit of emotion, as you had the Badgers and Marquette in the Elite Eight. And now it is Auburn to at least the Elite Eight. Are they going to be making a return visit to the Final Four as they did, I believe, in Minneapolis a few years back?
2019, wasn't it? The 3-point foul call with 0.3 seconds to go. Hard to forget that one. But let's put it this way. Auburn starts off with Yale. You got to like Auburn there. They get San Diego State, last year's finalist in the Final Four. So yep. That's certainly not easy. Certainly not easy. And, well, Auburn got a 4 seed, and they're ranked number 7 in the country.
How does that work out? If you're, you would think the 1 through 4 ranking should be the top 4 seeds. Then 5 through 8 would be the 2 seeds. 9 through 12 would be the 3 seeds. So to be a 4 seed, you would think you'd be ranked 13th through 16th in the country. And where's Auburn ranked?
Well, they're ranked number 7 in AP in the country. And, you know, that's an interesting discussion because the NCAA is supposed to keep people close to home. Yet the NCAA is sending Auburn from Alabama to Spokane, Washington. They're sending the University of Alabama to Spokane, Washington. And they're sending UAB from Birmingham, Alabama. So I don't know how it prevents families, kids from, it seems unusual.
And I do have Alabama-Birmingham upsetting San Diego State, and where you do have an Alabama-Alabama matchup with Auburn. I do have Auburn winning before falling to UConn, but I'll certainly be with the not with you physically. Maybe I'll try to join you in Boston. That would be fun. I'll definitely be with you rooting for Bruce Pearl, whether I'm there or not. And the other side of that bracket's really interesting.
Well, look at it this way. I will be with Auburn. I will be with Marquette. I will be with Wisconsin. I will be with somebody. And yes. It would be nice if they could all join up.
Yep. You'll hopefully be following them all, right? Which is, that is possible, correct?
It's very possible.
Yes, it is the way the brackets work out. Sometimes do a good trick there. So BYU is the best shooting team in the country. I like BYU. I see them winning a few games in this tournament before they run into that hot Iowa State team from the Big 12. So that's kind of that other Sweet 16 matchup. I have Iowa State defeating BYU.
Oh, you have BYU over Illinois, huh?
Yep.
Well,
I think BYU just shoots them out of the gym. And I've seen BYU lose to bad teams on the road. I've seen them beat good teams, but BYU can shoot. I see Big Ten's had some struggles in the NCAA tournament. I don't know if it's a trend or what it is, but for me, it's tough to bet against that. What we've seen the Big Ten do in the tournament the last few years.
He played Pope. Didn't he have a cup of coffee? Didn't he play for the Bucks for like a year? The coach of BYU?
Yes.
He was a Buck.
He was a national champion at Kentucky.
Kentucky, right. But more Wisconsin influence.
Yep. So, all right, you have Iowa State coming out? I know you like their coach.
Oh, I have Iowa State against Auburn, yeah. Iowa State is very, very, very well coached, and they play hard, and what more do you need to say that I think going into this weekend, Houston was one, not Connecticut. I think Houston was the one seed, or they were two at the worst, and they lost by 30 points to Iowa State. I mean,
T.J. Otzelberger, right? Wisconsin native.
Thomas More High School.
Yeah. What an amazing story for a Wisconsin native who loves the state of Wisconsin, who recruits Wisconsin kids, right, to Iowa State. I mean, he does a great job recruiting Wisconsin. Has Iowa State
a freshman? I think he's from Pewaukee. He has a freshman who averages about 12 or 13 a game who starts, a 6'7", 6'8" kid, and he recruits Wisconsin, yeah.
Wins the best conference in America, which is part of why Bruce Pearl did get bumped down off the 2 or 3 line, because he had some of these teams win conference tournaments, but Bruce did too. So this bracket, you have the 1 seed UConn, who won the Big East, the 2 seed Iowa State, who won the Big 12, the 3 seed Illinois, who won the Big 10, the 4 seed Auburn, who won the SEC. Is that possible? This one bracket has the top 4 conference champions there?
Seems like an odd thing to do to the supposed top team in the country, UConn, to put all of these champions in there. You're bunching 3 of the 4 final four teams last year, too, which, never forget that.
Right.
San Diego State and Florida Atlantic played in the Final Four last year.
Well, after all of that run, I still have UConn getting it done over Iowa State, my third consecutive Big East team into the Final Four alongside Marquette and Creighton. Auburn versus Ohio State, David.
What did you say?
Who do you have? Auburn versus Ohio State.
What do you mean, Iowa State?
Oh, Iowa State. Yes.
You got me nervous. Oh. He's still trying to get the coaching job there. War Eagle.
War Eagle. It is Auburn to the Final Four. So David now has Marquette, Purdue, and Auburn in the Final Four. I have a trio of Big East squads with Marquette, Creighton, and UConn. We'll figure out the West and then see what happens when they all meet in the middle as our bracket breakdown continues. David Gruber, Craig Karmazin, and you, ESPN Milwaukee and Wisconsin On Demand.
More Bracket Breakdown with Craig Karmazin and David Gruber coming up on 94.5 ESPN.
Gabe Neitzel here. I know you've already heard me talking about how Mentality has helped me over the years, but there are others like me. Jason has been using Mentality for a while now and is loving the results.
I have gotten a handful of friends, probably a couple dozen, especially those that are closer to my age, maybe even a little bit older, because I just tell them, you got to check this out. Do not wait any longer. Just go and admit it. Yep, you're at an age where things are slowing down. I promise you, you're not going to regret it. And that's truly what I get. I'll get a phone call after, like, man, I feel like a kid at Chuck E. Cheese right now.
Learn more today at MotiUSA.com.
We've told you about Moses Adara,
the diamond cutter who created the Kessler 81.
The magical diamond that vibrates with light.
Kessler's works with crazy diamond cutters.
Geniuses who create wonderful, spectacular,
crazy diamond shapes.
The one thing these crazy genius diamonds all have in common
is that they explode with light.
The Kessler Emerald Cut Diamond sends out rippling waves of light, like water lapping onto a beach.
The Kessler Square Radiant Diamond glows like the sun on the horizon.
Sometimes sunrise,
sometimes sunset.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Come to Kessler's.
Ask to see the rippling waves of light, like water on the beach.
Ask to see the glow that looks like sunrise and sunset.
Ask to see the Kessler Crazy Genius Diamonds.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
See them for yourself.
To find the Kessler's nearest you, visit kesslersdiamonds.com.
I'm attorney David Gruber. You've heard our slogan thousands of times, but we are much more than just one call. We are one team, one community, one family, and we're the one law firm that can get you the results and compensation you deserve after a serious accident. Call Gruber Law Offices today. One call, that's all.
It's time for the Milwaukee Basketball Report on 94.5 ESPN. Brought to you by National Liquor Mart, located at 16th and National in Milwaukee. National Liquor Mart is packed with deals for all your beverage needs, where your satisfaction is their plan of action. Open 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily.
It was the Bobby Portis Show on Sunday at Fiserv Forum as the crowd was chanting Bobby, Bobby, Bobby with every shot.
Lillard the other way, feeds it off. Portis fires up another three, and he tickles the twine. Yet one more time. He is a flamethrower today. 22 points in this half.
He'd finish with 31 in the game, a 140-129 Bucks win over the Suns. Chris Middleton also returned to the lineup for the first time since February 6th. He puts up 22 points on 8 of 15 shooting well. Next up, Bucks are in Boston for a big matchup against the Celtics. That one tips off Wednesday at 6:30.
This has been the Milwaukee Basketball Report on 94.5 ESPN. Brought to you by National Liquor Mart.
For over four decades, one name has stood out as a symbol of excellence in automotive sales and service. It's the Boucher Automotive Group, dedicated to providing exceptional experiences to all of our valued customers.
We will help you find the perfect vehicle within your budget while respecting your time.
With 20 convenient locations, we're the one-stop destination for all your automotive needs.
At Boucher, we're your trusted partner on every mile of your journey. Riding with you every mile since 1977.
Check out our brand new Hyundai dealership, one of the largest in the Midwest.
Step inside of our state-of-the-art showroom where you can view our new Hyundai models and some of our finest certified pre-owned.
We've also expanded our service center, staffed by our factory-certified technicians.
And right next door, we've started construction on our all-new Genesis of Waukesha dealership.
But we're not just building walls, we're building careers.
So if you're looking for a career with great benefits and opportunity for growth, Boucher's the place for you.
At Boucher, we ride with you every mile.
The Bracket Breakdowns continue right now. You're listening to Bracket Breakdown with Craig Karmazin and David Gruber on 94.5 ESPN.
Oh, it is the final four, and that means we need to get to the fourth region, and that is the West, which is where you'll find my champion of the NCAA tournament. Yes, in the West region, which has some big brands there, right, with North Carolina and Michigan State on the top of the bracket and with Arizona on the bottom of the bracket. We've already talked about the idea of New Mexico going and being that 11 seed that makes it to the Sweet 16. I also like Grand Canyon. They're a team that I think they've been in the tournament now 3 of the last 4 years. I watched them play once this year. They are a great team. And I've watched St. Mary's play 3 times this year. And it was 3 times too many. I think they lose in that 12-5 matchup. I really like Grand Canyon in that matchup against St. Mary's. I do like Alabama. I like North Carolina to win a few games. You said you actually like Tom Izzo to go down in the first round of the NCAA tournament? Is that possible?
Mississippi State. Michigan State wins because they're physical and tough all the time. I don't think they're going to out-tough Mississippi State. They're very physical, Mississippi State. So, yeah, it's 8-9, obviously, but my guess is 80% of the country will pick Michigan State because Izzo's fantastic tournament coach. But, yeah, I just kind of went with Mississippi State there. Yeah, and I was hoping that after they won that one, they'd beat North Carolina, but I don't know about that.
Tom Izzo is 55-23. 55-23 in the NCAA tournament.
Well, they ambushed and, you know.
I mean, that is
they beat
impressive.
Marquette last year. Don't forget that. That's the dreaded matchup, Michigan State.
I know, and Marquette was the better team, I felt Marquette like, going into it, team, right? And Tyler Kolek didn't, you know.
Well, he played hurt in that game,
yeah,
if you recall.
Yeah. So you're going with Mississippi State. And then do you have Mississippi State upsetting North Carolina?
No, I wanted to, but I don't. I have North Carolina winning. I have Alabama winning a couple of games, much to my chagrin. I have New Mexico winning 2 games, including like you did, and I have Arizona. So my final four in that region are North Carolina, Alabama, New Mexico, and Arizona.
That's exactly mine.
And I have Arizona beating North Carolina.
I have Arizona beating North Carolina. I have Arizona. Oh, actually, finally, a Big East team loses. I have Arizona beating UConn.
Ooh.
And then, ooh, that is a tough matchup. And then I have Arizona beating the Marquette Golden Eagles in the national championship game after Marquette gets by Creighton. Arizona over MU. That is the final matchup.
Well, if you're looking for me to say Auburn's going to lose a game at this stage, if they could survive the University of Connecticut, if they could survive Iowa State, you almost have to say, well, geez, hope you don't think you won it already.
Yeah.
Because what is Iowa State? I mean, think about it. Iowa State is what, are you ranked 3rd or 4th in the country right now?
Yeah. And so then you have them beating Arizona to go to the national championship.
I do.
Where they will take on?
Well, let's just
Purdue
say
or Marquette.
Let's just say that Purdue had it too easy. And if, you know, if Auburn plays Marquette, I just don't know, you know, where to sit, what shirt to wear, what hat to wear, or, you know.
I mean, but you only attended one of those universities, which was Marquette.
That's right. My whole family.
War Eagle versus the Golden Eagles in the national championship for David Gruber. That is your bracket.
Yeah, well, it's hard to root against. If they're shooting my shirts in the crowd at Marquette, it's hard not to root for him, huh?
Yep, exactly.
I'd love to have that dilemma. I'd love to have that problem.
I don't think, it looks like you have not, he has not filled it in.
Oh,
he
no,
has not
I did
filled
not.
It in.
I did not. I.
That is not, you're going to be ineligible for the tournament challenge with
it's
ESPN.
A dangling
you're
going to be participle. I have not a.
Yes, a hanging chad in your election ballot. You will not officially be able to enter that bracket.
Just like a couple of teams I watched this week, and I just couldn't close on this.
Yes.
I came very close, but I couldn't close.
Well, it'll be very interesting to watch these teams close because the NCAA tournament begins pretty much now, right?
Tonight in Dayton.
Yes, Dayton, Ohio, the site of the first four of the NCAA tournament as it gets going tonight with 2 16 seeds. And then it is that Colorado State Virginia game. So Tony Bennett in action tonight on True TV, the one time a year to figure out, do you have True TV on your cable system? It is a big question that we all deal with on Tuesday. And remember, Milwaukee Bucks in action tomorrow night against the Boston Celtics. David, appreciate you joining as always. This is an amazing tradition and so fun.
I love it, Craig. Thank you for having me.
Yes.
Everybody and, enjoy. It's it's a great time of year.
I mean, do we have any like... Okay, Josh, I'll just sing it. For Josh DiMaggio, David Gruber, Craig Carmson, you've been listening to Bracket Breakdown, ESPN Milwaukee, and Wisconsin On Demand. Have a great rest of your day, everybody.
Hey, so have you tried fried chicken from Quick Trip? Ooh, freshly cooked, hot, and ready. And I'm talking jumbo, hand... Hey, so have you tried fried chicken from Quick Trip? Ooh, freshly cooked, hot, and ready. And I'm talking jumbo, hand-breaded chicken tenders, boneless wings dripping with all your favorite sauces. Or how about 8 pieces of fried chicken deliciousness? Perfect for your next large group meal. I mean, this is fried chicken that slays. I'm not talking about the runway. Slays appetites, fills you up. This is no ordinary chicken. It'll make any meal extraordinary. Quick Trip, fried chicken, ready for your next meal. See you next time.
Hey, Milwaukee, we make it easy.
It's a promise we made in 1964 and continues now, 60 years later, making car buying easy for families across South